More.
This week on NBA
Every 2K16 there, the challenge.
Break down the 2K Prime road to the finals results.
Afternoon here.
Take you behind the scenes at all the All-Star events.
Get it, I need it steady. Woo. No one give it, I'll give it. They don't love us, they just...
It took way longer than it should, and it was driving me to taking the custom thumbnail in for it.
Yo, look towards the darkness. Nah, yo, look towards the light. Yo, what the? Yo, what is that? It's a supernova.
Nah, man, that's a black hole.
Yo.
That's just,
I leap over lies in a single pound. The black prophet, one day I got struck by knowledge of self. It gave me super scientific powers. Now I battle in my arch nemesis, Mr. Ignorance. He's been trying to take me out since the days of my youth. He feared this day will come. I'm hot on his trail, but sometimes he slips away because he has an army. They always give me trouble, mainly hatred, jealousy, and envy. They attack me, they think they got me.
Not just for Twitch, but for
Steph Curry and the Warriors really next game.
Purposes for
I've been looking forward to this for a while now.
For you too, dude.
You know they'll be running and gunning.
If that screen cap.
It's gonna do two or three things that make you want to stop and stare, but we can't let that distract us. Because if we lose focus for even a second, they'll be up 20. So maybe it's up to me to put on a little
thumbnail images. You see a lot more on the family custom thumbnail images from now on and the videos, VODs and the
Real quick.
Free for there for a second. I'm trying to figure out what's going
on. As they take on their Western Conference rival in today's game, there's no better time of year than the holidays for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Welcome, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. Taking a look at Golden State winning their last three games. They'd like to make that four in a row here tonight.
And seeing where the Warriors.
Warriors leading by six. What a year for the Warriors. Clark won their division for the first time in 39 years, ran away with the very tough Western Conference.
And there were a number of surprises last season, Kevin, but the Warriors were at the top
of
the
list.
I don't think anybody, including you and I, pegged them to be as good as they were.
Especially the way the finals began.
Exactly.
And so in the game for the Jazz, Freak in its small forward. Hood out there with Trey Burke. Then there's Trevor Booker. Break, dishes to Burke, connects from point range.
And the Warriors won 51 games back in 2014, improved that mark by 16 wins last season. Among teams that won at least 50 games in the previous year, that 16-game improvement.
We need to calm down. We're taking too many shots early in the clock. Let's get some ball movement and run something on the offensive end.
Not only can they pass, they can fill it up, the highest scoring point guards this season. Second, Stephen Curry.
Well, this is a collection of maybe the most well-rounded players in our league. I mean, to see those kinds of scoring numbers from the point guard position
is crazy.
Yeah, and that's the age we're living in right now. I mean, it's not uncommon to see a
player. That's not a foul. That was fucking good defense. Almost unheard of. And these guys are all
capable of carrying the scoring load for their team on any given night. It goes without saying the Warriors set franchise records all over the place with their play, their win total being the highest ever. But also of note was it was the first time they've won 50 games in back-to-back seasons. They seem to truly have arrived as a top-notch franchise in this current state of the NBA.
Now here's Freak, covered by Barnes, feeds to Hood. A picture-perfect screenplay and the jumper's good.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Spates sets a screen. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Egg.
Some of Harrison Barnes' teammates have referred to him as the senator because of the way he carries himself. And, you know, a very level-headed, dignified young man. And just he has an air about it.
No good at the stripe this time. Second misses also.
And how about Harrison Barnes, the Black Falcon? I mean, he was a high school phenom.
It's not bad shot selection. It was not fucking missed. Back in 2012, that's a lot of crap. Double of crap.
Carolina. Remember also in high school, he was a teammate of Dougie McBuckets. And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Burke kicks to Booker. He feeds it to Freak. Pass to Booker. There's a good screen. Burke, the pass to Hood. Five on the clock. Booker dishes to Hood. Lets it fly. Not enough on that one as it misses.
I got the rebound.
Harrison Barnes, of course, went to North Carolina. Grew up as a huge fan of former Tar Heel Michael Jordan.
Yeah, you know, interesting. His mother started taping Jordan's games on the VCR years before he was born. His given name, Harrison Bryson Jordan Barnes. How about that for a factoid?
I didn't know that.
Nor did I.
Here's Hood, guarded by Kerr. Booker, and he banks in the layup. Booker's got his first points of the game.
Excellent assist there. Just led him to the perfect spot.
Curry gets to Azili, and there's the pass to Barbosa. They set the pick. Curry attacking. It's good for a second make. He's made two or three so far.
And those are two teammates right there working in rhythm. One setting the screen and the other using it to get that separation. And a chance here to check out some stats on Steph Curry. Just an incredible month of basketball. Fifth in scoring, 10th in assists. And he's as opportunistic as anybody defensively, ranking among the top 15 league-wide in steals per game.
And as you said, one of the NBA's most potent scorers, always up to the challenge.
Booker the pass to Freak. And stolen.
I got fouled. That was not a turnover. That was a foul. Again.
Here's the floater. And there's Stephen Curry.
That was a foul. That was a foul. Another foul. Again.
Utah's gone 2 of 5 from 3-point land here in the first quarter.
Glad to get away with it. Freak kicks to Booker. Game.
Here's Hood. Covered by Barbosa. Hood dishes to Freak.
You call the foul.
Just five to shoot. 18 feet out. Hood can't get it to go.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Nobody near Barnes. His three-pointers off the mark. Jazz trail by six. Now let's find out what head coach Steve Kerr had to say to Doris Burke. Doris?
Kevin, he told me he stressed to his players that what he wanted more than anything tonight was the extra pass. He said, we have a lot of guys on this roster that can be factors on offense. As long as we're keeping everyone involved, we can overwhelm teams with our scoring. Let's see if they can keep the rock moving and share the ball, guys.
Okay, Doris, well, the offensive approach, a primary force in the game plan today, guys.
Yeah, they are out to put up a big number today, and I think they can do it.
Well, that certainly seems to be the goal. I mean, it could be a shootout if their plans come to fruition.
Three streak with it. Guarded now by Barnes. Kicks it to Hood. The Jazz working the ball around now. Burke can't get it to go.
And even though he missed that, you have to take those shots when you get the opportunity.
Exactly. They don't come much better or easier than that.
Bounces high off the rim and drops.
Oh, poor crap.
And the Warriors lead by six.
He has such a nice touch for a big man.
Yeah, and they've got to figure out a way to get a bigger body on him. Because if they don't match up his size, then he's going to continue to work them over the rest of the
game. That selection. That was a bad thought selection.
No good.
Oh, the guy thinking there.
In the books. Warriors ahead, up six. And here's Freak on his experience as a one-and-done college player.
It was definitely a hard decision. I had to sit down with my family and weigh the options and really take the time to figure out what's best for me. It was tough. I mean, I loved my team, my coaches, and just the whole college experience, you know. But on the other hand, there's always a risk of injury, you know. I just felt like I was ready to take my game to the next level, so why wait? And I think it turned out for the best. No regrets.
Now with more and more freshmen, Clark, making the jump. Some changes here for the Warriors. Spates comes in for Andrew Bogut. And it's Barbosa in for Steph Curry. Then for the Jazz, Booker, he's checked in for Rudy Gobert. Freak comes in for Alec Burks.
Okay.
And Trey Burks subbed in for Dante Exum. Iguodala and Green are set at the forward spots. Barbosa is out there with Klay Thompson. And it's Spates in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the Warriors five. And it goes as the official calls the foul.
And the foul.
Shoot one more at the free throw line.
Here it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside.
Yeah, just getting the ball into the post has to be option number one for them right now.
And the Warriors making a change here. Barnes has checked in, and Utah also making a switch. Hood's checked in. Now here is Barbosa. Burke covering. Spates sets a screen. A shot by Thompson, and no one's around. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down.
Great job of utilizing that screen and finding space to knock down the jumper. Good basketball.
Favors passes to Freak. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. You look at Golden State. Here in the middle of the regular season, they've been able to get the fourth best record in the conference. And, of course, there's Utah, a game and a half out.
And, well, for the Warriors, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed. And that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Estes Azili, he's checked in for Golden State. Here's Barbosa. Booker pulls it in.
I tell you what, the defense should send Christmas cards for that miss.
Burke kicks to Freak.
Come on. Okay, I gotta go get Barry's. I'll be right back. There we go, sorry.
Dishes it to Booker. Passes it to Hood. The feed now to Freak. Gets to the rim for two with D all over him. Freak's got 7 points in the game. Well, the Jazz look like the team we're used to seeing for so long.
On the other side of the court where it's supposed to guard the
day. Was how they dictated the pace, Greg, of the game.
Very good point. I mean, the Jazz did a great job of slowing things down and avoiding turning things into a trap and just focusing on playing to their strength.
The dish to Booker. He kicks to Burke. Johnson with the rebound. Warriors leading by 7. Inside, here's Barnes. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. Well, we've seen some defensive wizards among the NBA's freshman class this season. Let's now take a look at the rookie steal leaders. 4th, Freak.
How about the anticipation and really his aggressive mindset defensively? He's always pressuring, always looking for an opportunity to force a turnover.
Yeah, and I think it's a unique talent and instinct he has. I mean, timing out the dribble, seeing the pass before it happens. Really excellent hands when he goes to strip the ball, and I think he's only going to get better.
Burke dishes to Freak. Booker up top. Burke the pass to Lyles.
Oh, foul.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2.
Yeah.
Check out some stats for Klay Thompson. He's one of the standouts over the last month, putting up about 22 points per, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. And he brings that offensive firepower to the team. Scoring just comes natural.
And, you know, defenses are throwing everything at him, yet he's still able to put up points. He's really unstoppable.
And we all know Utah is a very young team. Last year, only the 76ers were younger. Still very competitive given the age and the lack of experience from this group.
And they'll keep possession. Azili kicks to Barbosa. That's good. And the Warriors lead by 9.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
5 straight baskets, Greg, resulting from assists. They're playing as one unit out there.
Hood kicks the Freak. Pass to Lyles. Feeds it to Freak. Shoots from the right block. Good!
Yeah.
Freak's got 9 points. Clark, an interesting fact about the Jazz and their age last year. At one point, they didn't even have the oldest starting 5 in the state of Utah. Now, think of this. The starting 5 of BYU, Greg and I were just talking about this, had an older average than Utah did.
Yeah, amazing. You look at the ages of Exum and Gobert and Favors, it makes sense that that would be the case. Well, with the season the Warriors put together, they came out way ahead of everybody else in the West. I mean, given how tough the West was last year, that makes their 67-win season.
Why is it 35%?
All the more impressive. One of the best in history, in my mind.
The first one falls. Warriors took apart the West
Sorry,
last season. They went 42-10 against the rest of the conference. The games between them in second place in the West were the same as the games between second place and 8th. In the West.
And the Warriors didn't just pick on the little guys. I mean, they had big wins over the top teams in the West. Against the rest of the playoff teams, the Warriors were a whopping 20-5.
Jazz trail by 5. And Booker kicks to Freak. He dishes it to Booker. Nice ball movement by Utah. Now here's Freak. Defense right on him. Here's Hood.
Right open. Ugh.
With his 3. Golden State's gone 1-4 from 3-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Barbosa up top. He averages a bit over 6 points a game.
Boy, that's his 2nd foul, and he does not want
that was
to pick
fucking
up number 3
deal.
Here. That'll mess your game up for sure.
again. Again, why you think?
So much at that two-guard position.
Well, he can defend three positions, Kevin.
He can fucking...
Offensively, he does everything you want done from the two guards.
Knock the ball out of my hands by hitting my guy right in the arm. Certainly in the conversation. You get away with it, but two-way shooting guard in basketball. I don't even touch the guy. Really not much. He
Hood kicks the freak. They get it again. Here's Freak. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. It's going to be on Leandro Barbosa.
How about the game for Freak? He has 9 points, and he's made three shots at the foul line.
And you've got to take care of business at the free throw line. Not just getting there, but converting.
Free throw, good. Freak.
All right, and Thompson's much more active running the pick and roll lately. A great pocket passer, and of course the defense has to stay glued to him because of that ability to knock down shots.
They've been getting more and more physical as this game has gone along,
and it's starting to pay dividends. They've gotten a lot of trips to the line because of it in the second.
Damn it. Screen there, set him up. Yeah. With a terrific look. Come on, guys. The setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact that the
defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Offensive rebound. There's Freak. And two free throws coming up
as he misses
that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. And this is his fourth trip to the free throw line tonight.
His offensive approach tonight has been aggressive, and it's paid off with a lot of trips to the line.
Yeah.
And he clearly has been feeling it when he gets to that line.
Well, the term dream season can be applied to Steve Kerr's first year. Comes in and sets a franchise record in wins, and also wins a title for the Warriors in his first year. Still unreal.
Now here is Barbosa. Burke covering 11 feet away, and it's Barbosa again missing.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Burke dishes to Freak. Up and in for the basket, number four.
Yeah.
Makes him four for five now.
And that's his strong suit, the ability to find his way through the D and finish at the rim.
Thompson up top. He had 13 points in the win against Milwaukee. To the left side wing, Barnes. Off target from the wing.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of Ben.
Some ground for you to make up, no doubt, here in the first half. What are the areas you need to improve on to get back even with them?
I think we just need to step our energy level up a little bit. We seem to be moving around like we were playing underwater in that first half. Second half, we can come out with more urgency.
Good luck in the second half. Kevin, a visibly frustrated young man.
Only a three-point difference, though.
The third quarter gets underway.
At times, there were just too many guys at the three-point off, and
welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a... And the Warriors with some changes. Spates checked in for Bogut, and it's Barnes in for Andre Iguodala. Utah also making some changes. Booker, he's checked in for Gobert. Freak comes in for Burks, and Trey Burke subbed in for Dante Exum. So on the floor for Utah. Burke runs the show with Hayward at the two. Favors is out there with Booker, and it's Freak in at the three spot. Hayward with the ball. Now Green defending, and Hayward gets it to go.
Yeah.
Curry with it. 13 points in the game. Okay, well, let's check in with Doris Burke reporting from our sideline in this game. Doris, take it away.
No foul. That was a clean defensive play. Oh, look at it. You hit me. No, you didn't. Yeah.
Very few misses. passes from him all night.
Clean.
You really can't have a better shooting performance than that. He ended the game perfect from the field.
Great, Doris. Thanks. And a chance we see him top game performance right here tonight.
You know, I can't imagine he'd be able to pull off that kind of an outing.
Lying.
That's what the truly great ones are capable of doing.
Boy, even if he came close to matching it, that would be really impressive. But I tell you, that's asking an awful lot of one guy.
Okay. Here's Curry. Open shot, Thompson. Curry passes to Green. And a great assist by Curry.
I got the rebound in the lane. Son of a bitch.
7 points for
Draymond
Green. Jazz trail by three. Burke kicks to Favors. He feeds it to Freak. And Trey Burke gets the whistle that
thank
time.
Thank you.
That is his first foul of the game.
No,
the,
yeah,
nothing wrong with fighting for
it's
the
on
rebound,
them.
It's nailed with the over-the-back call.
How can you fucking...
You know, I was an offensive rebounder in my day.
Game.
And,
stop.
I like that kind of aggressive play. But he's got to do a little better job of trying to get position earlier in that case.
That's a good point.
In fact, that was...
Positioning is so vital when you're trying to rebound the basketball, and that's something that wasn't on display in that possession.
You know, even though he missed that one, great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
No doubt about it. The defense, you can see him exhaling right now. Fortunate that he didn't knock that one down.
That's good, and the Warrior lead is cut to just 1 point on the basket from Booker.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Yeah, and that's important because this game may ultimately come down to which team controls the paint in crunch time.
Here's Spates. Bounces high off the rim.
No. I got that.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Here I go, Jimmy.
Now here's Booker. 8 points for him. Green with the
come on, let's show it in.
For so long, there has been this mindset
again,
that Golden State wins through offense. But their defense,
your shot, should it go in or they should?
Yes,
it should not have gone in.
I think that's what's really allowed them to separate when you look at the rest of the league. I mean, they led the league in opponent's field goal percentage last season. And some nights, the shots weren't falling, but the defense always showed up.
And you know, with the Warriors, it goes beyond the stats. High character guys, tremendous culture. They had a lot of guys that could guard multiple positions and defend them well. That was a big reason they became champs.
And the Warriors making a change here. Azili's checked in, and Utah also making a switch. Miles checked in for Derek Favors.
What the fuck are you doing?
For a second to look at the top shooting
what are you doing,
Ian?
This
season. Curtis, Stephen Curry.
Some remarkable shooters in that group. I mean, you know that when
you see
foul
that
those types of numbers at the point guard position, you're talking about some very intelligent and patient players.
In addition to being unbelievably gifted shooters. I mean, these guys have some of the smoothest, sweetest strokes in the NBA, which means they have some of the best strokes in the world.
Ghosting hand.
And you just look at this Warriors roster, and there are a ton of defensive playmakers. That ability to switch everything and be fine is what made them.
That was a bad shot by someone in. If you get the bullet, and it ain't going
to
get it.
To be the first guy to it and get the putback.
And here's Thompson. He's got 11. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it.
Now a chance, Kevin, to take a look at how the
what
Jazz
is he doing
the last month.
There?
First in three-point field goal percentage, fourth in field goal percentage, and they are in the top 10 in team points per game.
And you look at their incredible three-point percentage. I mean, it's not just about their accuracy, but their execution using screens and creating those open looks. That's been key.
Now, Freak.
Oh, you fucker. That went right through his hands. It's not on me, it's on him. That guy just went right. Nope. Oops. Oops. It turns on that guy. That was a good pass. That guy just decided, oh, I'm not going to catch it.
Outside Curry. to the inside. Azili ran out of bounds as Utah gains possession.
What the fuck is going on here?
Utah comes into this one after the win against the Suns.
And how about the game plan that was constructed for that one? I mean, it was apparent how powerless the D was to stop it.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. I mean, they just didn't have an answer for anything they threw at them.
Exum with a wide-open look. Nails the wide-open jump shot. And now, just a three-point Warrior lead. Golden State's gone 3 of 7 from three-point range here in quarter number three. Curry dishes to Spates. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
And Maurice Spates last season with the best year of his career. I mean, he shot the cover off the ball and did a nice job on the boards as well.
Greg, you were just talking about Mo Spates. Clark, he has a great mid-range jump shot.
He does, and they actually call him Mo Buckets. But he actually played so well last season, they even threw in Mo VP from time to time.
Now here's Freak, covered by Barnes. And that one's good. 6 points for Dante Exum. Warriors leading by three. 41 seconds left in the third. Goes up on the block. Rebound, Utah. Here's Freak. 15 points in the game. Exum with it. Pass to Freak. To the middle. And Exum gets it to go on the assist by Freak. Freak's got 3 assists now in this one. Last outing for Golden State, they won that game against Milwaukee.
Was not even close. I mean, they had points coming from all over the place.
Yeah, they stayed true to the game plan offensively and never strayed at all. Impressive performance.
Thompson for three. Cannot hit. Three quarters of play in a close game here. Warriors ahead, up by one. We've got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back the fourth quarter. Spates checked in for the Warriors. Barbosa comes in for Steph Curry. And a switcher also for Utah. Freaks checked in. Thompson and Iguodala on the perimeter. Maurice Spates out there with Bogut. And it's Barbosa in at the point. That's the Warriors 5. It's Thompson off the drive. He hits it from 9. Thompson's got the lead up to 10 now for the Warriors.
Back on in.
He was great in his last game, Clark, and clearly he has not lost that love and feel.
Gobert with a screen on Thompson.
Stop ignoring me.
Exum passes to Gobert.
Why'd you pass there? What are you doing, AI?
Iguodala up top. Burks covering. He scores his 5th field goal.
No, that's not going to get those
5. Wow, has he flipped a switch at halftime. Much more effective here in the second half.
Exum,
passing to somebody who's
back to Gobert. Nice ball movement by Utah. Out to the wing. 6 on the shot clock. Burks kicks to Freak. Tries from 16. And it's Spates with the rebound.
Again, can I go to the game?
Rebounds in this game. Dishes at the top. 1:43 left in the fourth quarter. Barbosa for 3. Utah with the rebound. Freak's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Kicks it to Exum. Down low. A 10-footer. And that one's good. Freak.
Bad matchup for the defense, no doubt about it. Doesn't have the height to influence the shot there. Never mind blocking.
Now here is Barbosa. And the foul called on Freak.
That will get him his 4th foul.
That's his 4th foul.
Again.
I'm sure he recognizes the
situation
because number
5
put him in a rough, tough spot.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Green, he's checked in for Spates.
How's the team? If it's breakup down made by the other players, that might be
no question as to which team gave the better effort tonight.
Oh, God, what are you doing?
And as we watch the game wind down, you have to look back, Clark, at all the second chance points these guys generated.
Kevin, they clearly won the second chance points category, and possession after possession, we watched them go after the loose balls and the misses and turn them into makes.
And so they'll stretch their victory total to 19 on the season.
And with this win now, we're all square, 1-1. Two more games yet to come in what's proving to be a very competitive season series.
Boy, I tell you, look at these teams, Greg. They're very evenly matched. This could be one of the better in-conference battles we see
and
this
the
season.
Foul.
Just a quality win, and you look at the box score and some really good numbers for Green. You look at the energy he brought on both ends of the floor, and it's easy to see why he was a difference maker.
26 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And they can just dribble the ball until the buzzer.
Yeah, exactly. They got to be happy with the outcome here.
Elated, you're right. Barbosa dishes to Curry. Sinks the triple. And the Warriors lead by 12.
Just a terrific job of taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And, Greg, those fans had a hand in the win. I mean, they gave this team a big lift throughout the game. I thought there was great energy in the building.
Come on, that one in. Knocking it out of the basket, man. That's against the NBA rules. I know you're doing it. I know. That's against the NBA rules.
That extra little bit of confidence.
Steph, and a big win here at home, obviously.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Kevin, much appreciated, and now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Stephen Curry.
I will say this about Steph Curry. There is no player in the league more capable of single-handedly taking over a ball.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you enjoyed.
Good.
The only color I care about is green, money. Now, you've certainly made some money so far, Freak, but it's time we make more money. I'm talking movies, TVs, endorsements, even your own brand Jordan sneakers.
I care about the game first, Dom. All that sounds great, but don't you think it's a little too early to be talking about all that?
Too early? LeBron was 12 years old in sixth grade when he was thinking Space Jam. It's never too early to take and make leaps.
I guess.
You guess. This isn't high school. This isn't college. This is the real world. And the real world is fueled by one thing.
Oh, money.
That's right.
Money.
Money. Dollar bills, y'all. Why do you think they put presidents on them? Because that's what presides over us. I ever tell you guys about the first dollar I ever made?
No, Don, but you're about to.
Yo, check this out. CC, this is a great story, right? So I'm 7 years old, Queens, New York, 1973. My older brother Lonzo, he's got a lemonade stand. So that summer, I'm like, Lonzo, you know, let me help out. Let me make a couple of bucks with you. He's like, all right, Dom, come on. I'll teach you the business. So I'm pouring tons of sugar. I'm squeezing the lemons. I got the lemonade stand all set up. I'm like, yo, I got this, right? So I'm watching during the course of the day. I'm noticing something Lonzo's doing. He's not charging for refills. That summer, I convinced Lonzo, no more free refills, and we make $2,000 plus tips. Today, Lonzo's Lemonade is a national brand and publicly traded.
Oh, wow. That's dope.
I'm not here to impress. I'm here to improve.
It is.
To assist. I'm like the Italian-American Magic Johnson, running point for Team Freak.
No.
The only person running point around here will be me.
CC. Look at my watch. What do you see?
Not this again. I've seen the movie.
This is diamonds and platinum. Gold, forget about it. Silver, forget about it. This is diamonds and platinum. It's power and speed, Freak. This is what you have. You are on your way to being the biggest thing in the NBA. I'm proposing now that we dominate off the court as well as on.
I can't believe I'm saying this, Freak, but Don has a point. You've been establishing yourself on the court, and now it's time to take it off the court. Brand Jordan sneakers, I mean, the possibilities are endless.
Listen, Freak, You're going to have to decide the legacy you want to leave. But I'm not some agent from the Yellow Pages. I'm Dom Pagnotti. I'm the man, the myth, the legend, the king, number one. I'm the best. And I'm a shark. And the Pagnotti shark is working for you. And we got to set new goals and bigger goals, okay? I'm talking all-star game. I'm talking dunk contest. When was the last time you saw an NBA great in a dunk contest, huh? I'm talking first team all-NBA, first team all-defensive team.
What about social media?
Yvette, great idea. Social media. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Let's kick it up a notch.
Right.
www.freakinandvibing.com. That's right. Your own website. I've already set it up for you, and it's running great.
Wait, hold okay? up.
Listen, I'm in negotiations right now on a feature that will allow viewers to watch Freak and only him and his plays during the game.
Yeah, but you set up a website without consulting me?
Yeah.
When did this happen?
Last week.
Uh-oh. Oh, this is going to be epic.
CC, I love you, but I got no time to waste, and you're out there busy doing whatever it is you're doing.
Whatever I'm doing? You know what? I'm really sick and tired of the disrespect. This is Team Freak, not the Dom Pagnotti Italian-American opera.
CC, calm down, all right? Dom here, he's just trying to take us to the next level.
Look, Ming Ching, I don't even know why you're here when your job is to look good and shut up.
CC, chill.
No, I'm done chilling. Between your clown agent and your gold-digging girlfriend, I've had enough.
Gold digger? You're the winner of the Lucky Sperm Contest, and I'll have you know I am currently starting my own fashion line. I've already got model contracts from Beijing to Milan, not to mention I graduated top of my class. Summa cum laude.
You mean thank you, laude?
I don't need a man to save me or provide for me, okay? I got my own. Boo.
Okay, well, if that's the case, then why has all your success and fame coincided with your relationship with my brother? I mean, if you're really on top of your game, wouldn't that have happened before y'all even met? Right?
You know what, CC? You're just jealous. It's okay, though. Why don't you just play the background, yeah? Enjoy the ride.
Y'all both done yet?
May I continue?
Yeah.
As far as movie properties go, I've already got a script based upon a story of your life, Freak, okay? So, guys, check out these possible titles. Freakin' and Vibin', Life and Times, Volume 1. The Freak Chronicle. Freak, the Fast and Furious, Part 1 does it. This one's my favorite, Freak. You're going to love this. He got Pagnotti.
Whoa, okay.
You love it, right?
Dom. Yeah.
You're going to tell the Freak it's going to be comedy. For me.
You have to follow my lead. I'm all for your
Freak
ideas.
Freak Fast and Furious.
Or one dozen. We'll discuss some of your ideas at a later date. Understood?
Yeah, we're cooling the gang, bro. That's all you had to say.
All right, good. Thank you. Vet, chill. You cannot let CeCe get underneath your skin. But on the same token, you cannot go out of your way to piss her off. I don't have time to be playing peacekeeper between you two.
You know what? We need to talk about this afterwards alone.
Fine. CeCe? CeCe? You need to hold this together. You and I both agree.
Yeah.
I know that Dom was the best agent for me. He has delivered. Are his methods questionable? Is he a shark? Yes and yes. But he is our shark. He's what's best for me, which means he is what's best for all of us. Your job is to bring us balance. Manage the team, sis. We all need to be on the same page.
You're right.
Yeah.
But blood is thicker than water.
You know, I ain't trying to hear all that. I'm not here to hold hands. I'm here to win games and achieve greatness on and off the court. But in order for that to happen, I need everybody to be on point.
Everybody.
Essentially, get right or get gone. Yeah, I don't have time to be teaching you guys how to work together. It either starts now or I find it elsewhere. Squashed?
Squashed.
Zucchini. Yeah.
The key.
Mr. Dom Pagnotti. Mr. Diamond and Platinum himself. It's a love-hate relationship.
What do you think about people who see your brother as just a meal ticket?
Well, that's why I'm there. I'm the gatekeeper. Yep. I can smell it from a mile away.
When you take time out of your own personal life, do you have a personal life?
I do.
Where at?
I just...
I think Freak is your personal life.
You can think whatever you want, mister, but I have a personal life, thanks.
Yeah?
Yeah. I think that should end the interview right now. Yeah? It's great meeting you.
We got James Harden in that beard of his. Look, this guy's relentless. We know he's gonna attack the basket all night long. So I'm gonna make it my personal mission to keep that from happening. As long as we keep jumping those passing lanes, we can give them a run for their money. I know I'll be ready.
Casting live, 2K Sports presents the NBA. It's Monday night. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. You can feel the energy inside Energy Solutions Arena. Jazz looking to please their fans in this Western Conference matchup. And this is the first season matchup for them against this Rocket.
Sorry, I just remember something I want to post on YouTube someday. They said something to a list and it was really stupid of them.
And this game kicks off.
Really, they put guys like no one wanted there. They put on a list and they didn't put on a list. It was really stupid. It's like, really.
Freaks checked in for Alec Burks, and it's Exum in for Trey Burke. Houston with a big group substitution here. Jones checked in for Howard. Brewer comes in for Monta Ellis. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for James Harden. And it's Lawson in for Patrick Beverly. Taking a look at the Rockets. Lawson out there with Thornton. Then it's Corey Brewer. Then it's Trevor Ariza. And it's Jones in at the five, home in the paint.
I mean, I like the call.
That was weird.
The defense was just there a little late.
Yeah, it looked like it. I mean, he kind of
slid underneath
as he got to the spot, too.
And checking out the numbers for Exum, how his last 10 games have gone. He's averaging 10 points a game, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. And you look at those numbers, not bad. But, guys, I think he can do better, and he knows.
And he has high expectations for himself as well, guys, but he just hasn't delivered fully on his potential yet.
And the Rockets have lost out on some free agent wars the past few years. They have remained competitive, but you wonder what could have been if they landed or kept some of those big names.
And with the Rockets, it's no secret that they take a very analytical approach to team building. Greg, you and I talked about that. And Clark, you know, you wonder if that hurts them in free agency.
Well, you know, when your front office makes no qualms about viewing players as simply just assets, it can be a hard sell to a free agent.
Me. That's right, didn't call it outside.
Brewer, yeah. The pass to Jones. And Lawson, here we go. Back to Jones. Houston moving the ball around. And the basket by Brewer.
Oh.
Brewer's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
Freak dishes to Hayward. Score of the basket is after five shots.
And he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Lawson outside. Pulls up. High post. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's one for two.
And really smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Showed nice basketball IQ. I agree, Greg. I mean, if he finds his spot on the perimeter and doesn't force it, I think his outside shot will be hard to block no matter who's defending him.
Six to shoot. Freak kicks to Hayward. And it's good. With time running down on the shot clock. Hayward's got eight.
Not an easy finish right there, but a beautiful move to give himself just enough space to get in close and knock it down.
Ariza has the open look. That three off target had some space there after the little pump fake. Freak with it. Now Lawson defending. Now here's Exum. Tight defense on him, and that one's good. Booker's got his second bucket tonight.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Ariza sends a screen for Lawson. Jones, the pass to Brewer, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Brewer's got his second bucket of the game to go.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And watch, Clark, how the game plays out, because this is going to open things up on the perimeter.
Hayward dishes to Freak. Back to Hayward. There's the pick. Off the screen. And it's
come on, went in.
Good little two-man.
Stop knocking my ball
out. Just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty. Good-looking shot, well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it. Tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here if he shattered the backboard.
Hayward kicks to Freak. The basket off the assist from Hayward.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
The high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempts, and that's just not going to get it done. They've got to figure it out.
On its way from Thornton for two, and it's Freak with the rebound.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Can't hit. The clear look at the hoop, he doesn't miss many of those.
Thornton passes to Lawson. Screen by Jones. Lawson kicks to Jones. Can't make good off the pick.
Most of the time, that shot will go down. Boy, the defenders have to make sure they tag him.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. The open shot by Brewer. Another miss by Houston. Outside for Lawson.
Oh, my guy was at that by that point.
There's the screen. Back to Thornton. Second chance shot. No good. Hayward. No luck. And that does it for the first quarter. Rockets lead by four. It's the NBA.
Probably tighter.
And Rockets head coach Kevin McHale spent some time with us in the broadcast. That That's an interesting perspective on competitiveness and what happens when you're no longer in the thick of it, especially, Clark, when you're as physical a player as McHale was.
Yeah, you know, I certainly understand where he's coming from. I mean, I'm living it in many ways, but for me, it's about the love of the game and sharing that with
God,
so many other people who love the
me.
Same things I do, whether they ever played or not. There's some common ground even outside of the competitive court.
And the first quarter is in the books. Second about ready to get underway. Let's quickly break down the game we've seen so far from the Rockets, guys.
And it's really about limiting their mistakes. And early on, they've been able to do that here in the first.
And, guys, I like what I've seen from them on the other end, forcing a few giveaways. And that's allowed them to widen that turnover margin.
So on the floor for Houston, Tony Unis and Howard, the post pair. Everly and Harden, they're the backcourt. And it's Brewer in at the three slot. Let's check out what Doris Burke has.
Yeah.
Freak, in the last matchup against the Grizzlies, made some major contributions. He ended with 13 points and played some lockdown defense as well, causing havoc on both ends of the floor. Overall, just an incredible bonus for his team as he made a big impact coming off the bench.
All right, thank you as always, Doris. And another special game from a player that we know incredibly capable for this team.
Yeah, and he proved his value again in that last game. I mean, he's a cog in their machine. No doubt.
Yeah, and they're going to need a few other players to lend a bigger hand today. I mean, they can't expect him to carry the entire load two games in a row.
And that one's good. Freak's got 4 points this quarter.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas.
Fires the three. Brewer's shot is off. Starting for Houston, it was a loss to the Spurs in San Antonio.
Probably their poorest defensive effort all season long. I mean, at home, that kind of D is not going to cut it. Never mind when you're on the road.
Hey, I don't know, guys. This may be all speculation. Perhaps they had a bad flight into town the night before, and we all know a rough flight in can lead to turbulence on the court. Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
And Corey Brewer, guys, out of Florida, remember, won those two national championships, teaming up with Joakim Noah and Al Horford. Terrific quickness, and that rangy frame makes him a disruptive defender. Great versatility as well on that end of the floor.
It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Brewer's got his third bucket of the night. Checked in for Freak.
Oh, great. That really worked out. It was a loss to the Grizzlies.
Yeah, their defense got sliced and diced in that game. They just weren't closing down.
That was a foul. You fucking throw, my guy hurt.
Of those point blank shots on the interior.
Foul.
Foul.
They kind of know they fell.
After a game like that.
To the paint, Miles. And he's still
looking
to make his first shot for
the
night.
In here, now
it's Harden with the drive. Rebound, Utah. Hayward's got his third rebound on the night. Exum dishes to Freak. Now here's Booker, defended by Jones. Here's Freak. The chance.
That went in there without bad shot selection.
Totally
lying again
glass,
at game
two. Definitely doing enough to keep this lead right where it is.
Yeah, but they've separated themselves, Clark, in a number of categories. Rebounds just being one of them.
To the middle. Lyles passes to Exum, and he uses the glass on the layup.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash-mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half. And that's sort of been the story here today, hasn't it?
So as we conclude...
Well, obviously a lot of ground for you guys to make up in that second half. Do you expect Coach to shake things up to try to jumpstart you here in the third?
Yo,
best of staying losing like this. Yo, if he needs any suggestions on what we can change, he can come to me. Because I've been keeping the list all half. About 5 pages long at this point.
Wow, Kevin.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands for the Jazz.
Trevor
Booker is checked in now for Gobert. Freak comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Hood subbed in for Alec Burks. And then for Houston, Terrence Jones is checked in for Monta Ellis. And Ty Lawson subbed in for Trevor Ariza. Freak, he's in at small forward. Hood out there with Burton. Then there's Favors, and it's Booker in at the four slot. That's the group right now for Utah. Houston leading by 18. Screen by Jones. Lawson drives in. Offline from the high post. Jazz have gone 7-15 from the field here in the third quarter. Burke kicks to Freak. And there's the pass to Booker. Feeds to Burke. Freak with it, and it's Harden picking him up. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Hood. And Utah again with the bucket.
Fellas, that's been a go-to shot for them today.
Yeah, and they found that sweet spot in the defense. And it's right between the paint and the three-point line. And boy, have they been rock solid.
And Lawson with the drive. Harden outside. Back to Lawson from the arc. That doesn't go either for Lawson.
Frozen. Guy is just ice cold, unable to contribute offensively.
Now here's Freak. Not a lot of room. Booker dishes to Freak. Pass to Hood. Puts it up from 15. And Utah again with the bucket. Rockets leading by 14. Howard setting the pick for Beverly. Dish now to Jones. Loses the defender with the screen and drills the jumper.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
Favors with the screen. Freak passes to Booker. And Favors kicks to Hood. Favors with a screen on Howard. Here's Hood. And there's another one for the Jams.
They're earning their points with the jump shot now.
And that's right, Clark. 6 of their last 10 have come from the mid-range.
Dishes to Howard. No good. And Utah the other way now. Now here's Burke. 10 points for him. Here's Booker. And off the front iron. And in it goes.
Yes.
Booker's got 11.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
That's got to be job number one right now. Nothing easy on the inside.
Howard kicks to Harden. And that comes off the assist by Dwight Howard. 15 points for James Harden.
And the interior D is really starting to be exposed here. How many layups have they gotten today? So a moment now to see the story on James Harden.
Okay.
The last 10 or so games, remarkable. Averaging 25 points per, 7 assists, and 7 rebounds. They're loving how he's running the show here. His sensational passing really breathing life into their offense.
You know, the scheme just seems to run much more smoothly when he's in the game because he knows where everybody is at all times. Thing.
He goes up again, and he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
You were doing stupid shit. That fucking passing you drove, you had no business driving the ball. So far.
Don't stop.
You had no business passing the ball there. Get there.
In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Houston.
So far, they've turned in a fantastic performance from the three-point line. It's been a weapon
again,
all game.
This is the
way they've been able to generate points off of the turnovers that they forced tonight has also helped.
The Jazz making a switch
again,
here.
Fell my call.
Miles checked in. Here's Hood. He's guarded by Thornton. Here's Freak. And a high bounce as it comes off the rim. Rockets leading by 15. Wasson outside. He feeds it to Howard. Thornton dishes to Harden. Jones sets the pick for Harden. Crops in the tray.
No.
Harden's got 12 points here in the second
half. Not gone
in.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Well, Dwight Howard had that.
Oh, you fucker. As he fell. You fucking fell, my guy. As he fell.
We saw back in certainly his younger days in Orlando.
Yeah, but nonetheless, Kevin, he's still in the conversation for best centers in the NBA. I think he remains a superstar big man when he's healthy.
They totally would have to fell. Called the fucking fell.
The freak. Nice ball movement by Utah. Here's Booker. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. Booker's got 13 points.
And you know, he's enjoyed the kind of day you expect in terms of shooting the basketball. He can bring them right back into this game.
Wasson drives in, kicks it to Howard. That one falls, coming off Wasson's feet.
There's no way to show it in. There's no way to fucking... Close to from where
and you remember back in Orlando, Dwight Howard, a three-time defensive player of the year, not to mention a slam dunk title. He's lost some of that lift, but still has more than just about any other center in our league.
A nice shot by Booker. He's got 15.
Well, as for them being behind in this game, you certainly can't put any of it on his shoulders. He's been tremendous offensively.
Right side Jones, stolen by Exum. And Exum with a clear path to the hoop. And the shot is good. Exum's got his second bucket tonight.
And how about that one-man fast break?
I love the power finish at the end of it, too.
Left side Lawson. Ball's knocked loose. Passes it to Howard. Shoots from 12. Takes a big high bounce.
Oh, bullshit.
Howard's
again,
got 14 points here in the second half.
Not going to fall in with a shit enough. That was horseshit game. That ball should not have gone in. None. No way. No.
Quarter action starting up. Derek Favors checked in for Utah. Freak comes in for Burks. And the Rockets making a change here as well. Beverly's checked in. So on the floor for Houston. Beverly and Harden, they're the backcourt. Mota Yunus and Howard, the post pair. And it's Ariza in at the small forward position. Burke kicks to Freak. Pass to Favors. Hayward against Harden. Hayward goes in. Mota Yunus grabs the miss. Mota Yunus has got 6 rebounds in the game. Harden dishes to Beverly. Mota Yunus, a screen on Gobert. Harden gets to Ariza. And he gets the bucket.
And I'll bet his percentage
is pretty high from that range.
Jazz trail by 18. Out to the right wing. Puts it up from 15. Here's Gobert.
Let my ball go in.
And gobbled up that rebound and went straight into attack mode. On the putback.
Oof, he is one of the most determined rebounders, Clark, we have got in the NBA.
Yeah, you're calling it right, Kevin. I mean, he gets so many second chance points because of how hard he works to get to the rebound.
It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. The feed to Burke. Now here's Freak, covered by Mota Yunus. Here's Freak. Rebounded by Howard.
Let the ball go in the basket like it's supposed to.
Here's Ariza. Gobert with the block.
Guys are looking for a spark
here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Favors sets the pick for Hayward. to the wing right side. Burke. The basket good off the assist from Hayward. Hayward's got three assists now in this one.
He's come out here in the second half and done a nice job moving, getting good looks, and finding his range.
And Beverly kicks to Harden. Down to five on the shot clock. Odie Unis has the open look. Another miss by Houston. Now here's Burke, defended by Beverly. And Hayward gets it to go.
As long as they keep spraying them from deep, we're going to have ourselves one exciting finish.
Yeah, it took them a while, but now they're starting to get into a flow from outside. And boy, is that time.
Harden against Hayward. Screen by Howard. Harden the pass to Monta Ellis. Terrific design on the pick.
Holy shit. And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Now here's Freak. Defense right on him. Favors with a screen on Beverly. And that one comes up a bit short.
High quality shot. Just a little off there with the release.
And Greg, that has him S-H-H-ing, shaking his head. Tough miss that time.
Did not get that bully. Yes.
That was some lying slick passing from Harden on that one.
Now here's Burke, defended by Beverly. Favors, dishes to Freak. And that one's good.
Really good example there of some fine interior passing before that basket.
Rockets leading by 13. Beverly with the ball. Rebounded by the Jazz.
Boy, I tell you what, guys, he's an extremely strong finisher. I'm surprised he wasn't able to power that through the defense.
Hayward outside. From outside the arc, it's good. The assist that time.
Yeah.
Hurts got assist number 5 here tonight.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
It really has, Clark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary in terms of dealing with their passing.
He kicks it to Freak. The shot from 20 feet away. Burke can't get it to go. The Rockets have gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. And he gets it to go.
A great job.
Oh, crap.
The ball
it didn't go
right
in.
Now.
Really?
Jazz trail
really?
By 12.
Really?
Favors with the screen.
Yeah.
Burke kicks to Favors. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the way up.
And that's got to happen if they want to have a chance to turn this thing around. I mean, he needs to just take the game over. I mean, it seems like he's been hesitant to pull the trigger.
To the inside. Howard. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Game? Why'd you do that? I didn't even try to block it. What the fuck are you smoking? They did that on his own, by the way. I never pushed
it. A lot more than they used to.
Favors with the screen. Now here's Freak. Reza covering. Hayward goes in. And in an era where so many guys take the money and run, Gordon Hayward did the best he could.
Live
up to his new contract, Clark, last year, a 4-year max deal signed heading into last season.
Yeah, and the way max contracts work nowadays, even the upper mid-tier guys are getting them. A trend that will probably continue, at least in the near future.
Getting back
in
the game.
There are only some, there are only a small number of
like,
guys
who
really max contract players in the NBA.
Houston making a switch here. Monta Ellis has checked in.
Really
Harden outside. In the corner. Monta Ellis with it. Lawson outside. Screen by Howard. Lawson the pass to Monta Ellis. And stolen by Freak. knocked loose and stolen by Lawson.
Oh, come on.
And it looks like just playing the last bit of this one out in what should be a nice win here for the Rockets.
Clark, the differential in assists led to a lot of open looks, and it also helped to get more guys involved in the offense easy.
They made the defense adjust by moving the ball like that, and there was no answer for it.
And so they'll stretch their victory total to 19 on the season.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
And, Greg, we know familiarity breeds contempt. I would expect things to become more heated as these teams face each other going forward.
And, as usual, great numbers and a dominant display for James Harden. He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
And it would take divine intervention for them now to get back in it.
And even that might not be enough.
Greg, what do you think?
Yeah, I'd have to say, guys, I don't think the man upstairs is really focused on the comeback.
Stop. Fucking
now, Ariza. He dishes it to Lawson. And the foul called on Freak.
A foul?
That's his first foul.
Again, you could fucking knock the ball out by hitting my guy in the arm. Not to go for Phil. I would have steal the ball out of your hand. Knock the ball out of your hand. Stealing the ball. And could call for foul.
Kevin, how about the mental toughness?
Coming off
the
2K Sports
Post Game Show. Where the fuck you lose badly? You play.
Many thanks, Kevin. So now we move on to our Dwight Howard. He simply had a dominant third quarter, and it quickly became apparent he wanted to exert his control. And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you enjoyed.
Egg.
I told you, Don Pagnotti always delivers. Brand Jordan Freak prototypes. Open the box, check
Man.
Them out.
My Christmas and my birthday on the same day. Oh. Oh, Don.
You love them?
I love them.
Hey, they're waiting for your approval for production.
Approved.
Approved?
Approved.
Done. I'll make the call.
In fact, now that we trust.
I told you you'd love
them. Man.
Hey, I'm going to have you playing in those in 30 days or less.
Oh, money. Oh, man.
Freaking and vibing. Hey, freaking and vibing.
Freaking and vibing to me.
Oh, no, no. I don't know. I don't know. Yeah.
I'm coming home. New York City, baby. I'll be honest.
Yeah, that's the wrong thing,
I'm pretty excited. Mama, Pops, Cece. Yeah, they're going to be there. Playing in front of them in an NBA uniform for the first time is going to be a special moment for me. And I know all of Harlem's going to be watching. No pressure, right? It's all good, though. I've been waiting for this my entire life. And now be ready.
Affair lined up for you today as the Utah Jazz come in for this one. Great to have you with us, everybody, live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan. Jazz leading by 9. Exum with it. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. Here's Booker. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
You couldn't have dreamed of a much better start here than they've had today.
I think the offensive game plan they came in with was right on point. It's worked perfectly, and the lead they already have is proof in the pudding.
The Knicks again. Making a switch here. Porzingis is checked in.
Inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
Now a chance, Kevin, to take a look at how the Jazz fared over the last month. 7th in three-point field goal percentage, 10th in field goal percentage, and they're in the top half of the league in scoring as well. Not too shabby.
And they've also enjoyed a lot of success from beyond the arc. I mean, as you can see by that top 10 ranking and three-point percentage, that's a shot they should continue to feature in their offense.
And it's free missing.
For the New York Knicks, they come in on the good outing against the Charlotte
Sixers. You know, they played well enough to win, but to be honest with you, I just felt like defensive performance was shaky
again.
Yeah, I'd go along with that, Greg. I mean, the game wasn't handed to them, but they definitely didn't have to work as hard for it as they should have.
Pass to Wiles. Now, here's Burks. He's covered closely, unloads from 9. Shots good by Wilds. And the Jazz lead by 9.
That's a nice job of getting the ball in the paint and burying the shot. That's exactly how it's done.
Boy, for Alec Burks, he really started to put it all together in his third season. He doubled his scoring average, shooting percentage was up. Then last season, a strong start, but a shoulder injury cut short what I thought was going to be his best season yet.
Nice shot by Porzingis.
Good night, don't you?
Here's Exum. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Now here's Freak. He's covered closely. Now here's Exum. Passes to Lyles. Wide open. And that comes off the assist by Exum.
He has such a nice touch for a big man.
Yeah, and they've got to figure out a way to get a bigger body on him. Because if they don't match up his size, then he's going to continue to work him over the rest of the game.
Porzingis passes to Amundsen. Over to the left wing. Lock at 6. New York needs to get off a shot. Porzingis can't hit.
The defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
Pass to Lyles. There's a good screen. Exum passes to Lyles. And Utah again with the bucket.
How about the start that they've gotten off to? Huge lead, and we're still in the first quarter.
And guys, it hasn't just been the scoring. I mean, they're playing tremendous defense, too.
Patience. Patience. Taking early threes is leading to long rebounds, which equal to transition points. Make the defense move.
NBA for the past 10 games. Fourth, great shot.
He's really showing what he can do. I mean, providing an impressive knack offensively for a first-year player.
Impressive for anybody at any age, too. I mean, he's been practically unstoppable at times. And now defenses are starting to game plan for him.
The offensive rebound. First shot, first miss. He's out of the blocks fast.
They have got to put a body on him, because otherwise, with his agility and athleticism, they're not going to be able to contain him on the offensive glass.
So here's Burks. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Charlotte. Here's Freak. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
Now a chance to see the numbers for Calderon. How's the last month of basketball been for him? Putting up about 10 points a night, 6 assists, and 2 rebounds. And guys, no question, he's a guy with some talent. But honestly, even he'd like to see those numbers improve.
And all indications are that he's been working hard on his game. It just hasn't shown up in the box score yet.
And they've clearly been the aggressors here early on, drawing fouls and working themselves to the line.
And that is always a good recipe for offensive efficiency and a key to their lead tonight.
Galloway, no good.
And you know what? That's one of those heat checks if he's taking shots like that.
Yeah, heat check or not, I don't care how hot he may or may not be. He's not making that one.
There's a screen. Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Calderon. High post shot. And it's O'Quinn with the rebound.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Calderon kicks to O'Quinn. New York moving the ball around. Sinks it. And the shot for Porzingis.
And I like that they're not settling. Getting the ball on the interior. 8 of their last 10 coming that way.
Sometimes you just got to man up and take a tough foul in order to stop these free runs to the rim.
Burks kicks to Freak. Feeds to Burks. Dishes to Freak. From 11 feet away, gets the front of the rim and out.
And
they're at a definite disadvantage.
And, you know, time will tell how big a factor that becomes in this game, guys, but if you're the coaching staff, it's certainly a point of emphasis.
It's rebounded by New York.
Fucker.
Amazon's got his third rebound on the night. Calderon kicks to O'Quinn. Porzingis passes to Galloway. The feed to Calderon. Here's the three. No good. And that does it for the first quarter. Transitioning from college to the pros can be a challenge for many players. Here's what Freak had to say about it. Good points, Clark. What role do coaches play in helping him? A different look for New York. Kyle O'Quinn, he's checked in for Kevin Serafin. Amundsen comes in for Robin Lopez. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Jose Calderon. And so in the game for the Jazz, Freak, he's in at small forward. Exum and Burks, their backcourt. Trevor Booker is out there with Lyles. And he was camped in the lane there, and he gets the 3-second call. And we've got a chance now to get caught up on how the standings are looking in the West as we make the push through midseason. Taking a look at Oklahoma City. And not a surprise, really, to see them sitting there in the number one spot in the conference. The excellent brand of basketball they've been putting on display lately has been terrific. And, of course, the Utah Jazz just way behind.
Right now for the Jazz, they've had their chances to kind of separate themselves from the pack this season. But so far, they haven't been able to capitalize on those opportunities.
Hey, they're amongst a big group fighting for the bottom few playoff seeds. And that's going to continue all the way through the end of the season. I think they'll get in, but it won't be easy.
And it's time for an injury report.
Okay.
A very somber tone over here on the sideline, guys. It does not look to be good news at all. We're into the heart of the season now, and that's the last thing this team wanted to hear. That's going to make their winter just a little bit longer, guys.
Thank you, Doris, for the update. We appreciate it, and we really hope for the best, as always.
Yeah, he's a tough guy. My guess is
he'll
be
back.
Oh,
you fucking foul.
And better than ever.
Thank you for the foul.
Right. I mean, there are just so many uncertainties when it comes to dealing with injuries, though. Let's hope for the best.
Again. Foul. And turnover.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Hornets was a big factor. He dropped in 15 points, but also came away with 5 big rebounds. Overall, just an incredible bonus for his team as he made a big impact coming off the bench.
Good job as always, Doris. Thank you, guys. What was your take on his performance?
Kevin, I really felt like he left it all out on the floor. I'll say this. It was a great, hard-charging effort.
Guys, when he's on, nobody's more fun to watch. And he was definitely on in that game.
Jose Calderon, he's checked in for Anthony. And both free throws good from Freak. 151 left in the first half. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
They set the pick. Galloway kicks to Amundsen. Can't get it to go. So Utah will take it the other way. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And one of the factors, Kevin, that really hurt them in that game, the lack of success at the foul line. We all know how much those free throw woes can cost you.
And it gave those opposing fans a boost every time another foul shot clanged off the rim. I mean, that's an easy way to get the home crowd in your grill. And for Dante Exum, first point guard chosen in the 2014 draft, number 5 overall, actually, he was taken over 2 other very talented and arguably more proven point guards coming in, those being Marcus Smart and Elfrid Payton.
4 on the shot clock. Back to Aflalo. Utah with the rebound.
And you know what? He's just not on his game. No doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Kicks to Burks from about 16. Now in the scoring column with that deuce. 1 for 2 this game. And talking about Dante Exum last year, he showed scouts were right when they said he isn't a finished product. He only shot 35% from the field. Put up much smaller numbers than other top rookie point guards, like, you know, what, Smart and Payton.
But looking 3 or 4 years out, you may be singing a different tune. And, Kevin, I think that's what the projections are when you look at this young man. He has length. There's a smoothness and a feel for the game that's raw, but still elite. That's why many scouts would still today take him over any other point guard in that draft.
Burks.
Egg.
And the first half is now in the book. Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin. In for New York. Amundsen comes in for Kevin Serafin. So Utah going with an almost entirely new group here. Booker, he's checked in for Gobert. Freak comes in for Gordon Hayward. Alec Burks checked in for Hood. And it's Dante Exum in for Trey Burke. They've got Amundsen. He's out there with Aflalo. Calderon is out there with Kyle O'Quinn. And it's Galloway in point guard.
That's the foul
for New York right now.
He fouled my guy. What a pass, man.
The tray. That's good. And so Galloway with the assist.
Looking at my guy over there. What the hell was that?
Sixth assist on the night.
Where was
Utah has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Booker dishes to Freak. And the shot counts. He's fouled. And it's a chance.
And
the
3-point. And one, baby.
In that tight, with that much of an advantage height-wise, there's just not a lot the defense can do.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Jazz.
I like the work they've done at the free throw line all throughout this game. They've been the aggressors.
They've consistently drilled the mid-range jumper tonight as well, which has forced the D to come out on
them. Here's the screen. It's deflected, and they'll keep possession. And now it's Burks running. He can go all the way.
Dunk at the
end of the break. Boy, he's just dangling from the rim after sending it through there.
You can see which team now has the swagger, Clark, right now.
Yeah, it's exactly. It's with them.
And, guys, that swagger can backfire because you don't want to get your opponent a little too riled up.
Amundsen, the pass to a flow. Rebound, Utah. Favors got six rebounds now in the game. Exum kicks to Freak. He feeds it to Exum. Now here's Freak. Defense is right there. A nice shot by Booker. Yeah. And now it's an 8-point Jazz lead.
The defense has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
And I'd be interested to know just how many of these attempts have come from inside of 5 feet.
Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Aflalo. And it's Freak missing.
Yeah, not bad. It's
New York's gotten going here in the second half from outside, nailing 3 of 4 from the arc. And Aaron Aflalo.
Look at that fucking shot.
Aflalo's got 13 points now in the quarter.
He's simply a machine at the offensive end. I wonder how far behind they'd be if he wasn't having this kind of quarter. Those defenders look like they're out of gas. I mean, they're getting pushed around on the low block.
Yeah, but they better rally soon because they've given up 3 straight buckets in the paint.
O'Quinn dishes to Galloway. Exum pulls it in.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
Knicks trail by 7. Calderon kicks to Galloway. Back to Calderon. He dishes it to O'Quinn. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And really nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And, Greg, they do need to get going. They wouldn't mind, you know, shaving a couple more points off that lead right away.
Well, if the defense keeps giving up easy baskets like that, it won't be a lead for long.
Burks, the pass to Freak. And here's Burks. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game.
Nice piece of work there. Get yourself a little space and pull the trigger.
1:35 left in the third. There's Galloway. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. And he gets it to go.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender,
probably a legal screen.
Fighting over and through that.
Freak kicks the Favors. Now, here's Exum. Guarded close. They get it back. There's Freak. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the
foul.
Really giving them fits. Yeah. They just can't find an answer for Freak. 9 points and 2 blocks. He's played a huge role in this game.
Even though he probably wasn't a big part of the game plan coming in.
The Knicks making a switch here. Anthony's checked in. Lyles checked in for Utah. Trey Burke comes in for Exum. Both shots good from the stripe.
And he's doing a great job at the charity stripe. It's easy to overlook, but those freebies can make the difference.
Galloway, the pass to Anthony. Here's the screen. Amundsen kicks to Aflalo, and he uses the glass on the layup. Aflalo's got 15 points in just the second half.
So far, going for more of an inside game here in the second half, and I like that. A little smash-mouth basketball, taking it inside.
Now, here's Burks. He's guarded by Aflalo.
Oh, taken fuck away you. By Anthony. What's that turnover?
1 second separating again. The shot clock and game.
My guy.
There's Galloway. Burke covering. Anthony drives in. A strong finish under heavy pressure.
Did not go in.
Now just a 3-point Jazz lead.
That was not an easy basket either.
Now Freak. The dish to Burks. 3-pointer. Shot is off.
That fucking last shot. He fucking took. What are you fucking eating at me? Yeah, I thought that should have been in.
for New York. Utah also making some changes. Favors comes in for Lyles, and Freak subbed in for Gordon Hayward. So on the floor for Utah, Favors and Gobert, the shot-blocking duo inside. Put out there with Trey Burke, and it's Freak in at the threesome.
And you know what? They're winning, though, despite the fact that he has just been really off.
Sort of get the end of the roll.
There's the pick. There's Galloway.
Even
the
edge on it.
There's Lopez. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Gobert. And so he's picked up his final foul. He will sit for the rest of this game. Jeff Withy, he's checked in for the Jazz. You look at the numbers for Robin Lopez, Clark, they won't blow you away, but his impact is a lot bigger.
Exactly, Kevin. I mean, he's unselfish as a player, does all the little things. He's not focused on his numbers or shot attempts, and that's a welcome deal for coaches and teammates. He just wants to help his crew win.
Now here's Freak. He's tightly guarded. Good! Knicks trail by six. There's Galloway. Shot clock at six. He kicks it to O'Quinn. And lots of contact there.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
Exactly. The defense determined not to allow the easy layup right there. They'll settle for making him earn the free throws.
And Utah making a change here. Hayward's checked in. And so O'Quinn nails both of them. So it's Utah now. They've held a 12-point lead earlier. Burke kicks to Hayward. Down low. It's tipped. It's
of course, you wait till after. That's a good time. A follow outside.
14 feet away. That's in there. Anthony with
what
the
assist. Fuck, AI? Anthony's got are you doing? In the game.
Jazz have gone 5 of 10, 50% from the field. Three-pointer. Hayward, good on the shot. And the Jazz lead by 5.
Confident and composed on the three-point shot at a critical juncture. Clutch.
Here's Galloway. Burke covering. And Lopez has it in the corner. Now follow kicks to Galloway. Lopez dishes to Anthony. And good on the basket.
Oh, he's gonna hit this.
Anthony's got 5 points in the quarter.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all day. Even last game, he was on fire.
Burke and O'Quinn sends it back. Sure. Here's Galloway. And there's the pass to Anthony. New York moving it around. And a little hug that time, but it drops.
Goaltending. Goaltending.
Utah has gone 3 of 4 from downtown here in the fourth.
That basket's in the canvas.
Now here's Freak, covered by Anthony. Burke kicks to Freak. And it's O'Quinn with the rebound.
Again.
O'Quinn's got his fourth rebound with that last
again.
One here tonight.
Looking here, man.
There's Galloway. Poked away. And out of bounds as the Jazz gain possession.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Kevin Serafin, he's checked in for Kyle O'Quinn. And a switcher also for Utah. Burks, he's checked in for Rodney Hood. Pass to Freak. Feeds it to Hayward. Passes it to Burks. Dishes to Freak. 5 on the clock. Unloads. Releases from the wing and drills.
Yeah.
Well, nothing was going down for him in the first half, but since the break, he's been on target.
Knicks trail by 3. Galloway, the pass to Carmelo. A step back shot here. That one bounces around and comes back out.
You know, there are those who wonder if Gordon Hayward can lead a team to the promised land. However, as just a
and the bomber. He led a non-powerhouse stuff like spell like that. That's gigging so many things. We don't like
from winning it all.
Lance Thomas, he's checked in for Kevin Serafin. Going back to Hayward, he took that buzzer-beating half-court shot, Clark, that would have won his school the championship. You actually called that game, and it did hit the backboard and rim, but unfortunately did not go in.
Well, Hayward's the kind of guy who's willing to put his team on his back and try to carry him. He's willing to take that responsibility on. Whether he can deliver at the highest level, time will tell.
Jazz leading by five. Burke dishes to Hayward. Out to the wing. From the line. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. 15 points for Freak. Knicks have gone 6 of 12 from the field here in the fourth, and even 50%. Here's Callaway, and it's Freak with the rebound. Freak's got 6 rebounds in the game. Pass to Burke. There's the 3. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. Avalo's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
But still, eventually, you got to feel like he'll start knocking those down.
And it's out of bounds to New York. They'll retain possession.
Oh, nice play there to get a hand on that pass and tip it out of bounds.
Just a whisker away from coming up with the steal there.
Clay Anthony Early's checked in for New York.
When he's wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
That's good.
Yeah.
The Jazz lead by 9.
We've seen a noticeable improvement out of him since halftime. He didn't have a whole lot working in the first half.
It's Carmelo Anthony on the wing. That's good, and so Galloway with the assist.
No.
18 points for Carmelo Anthony.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Again. Nicely done.
Burke kicks to Freak. And there's the feed to Favors. Burke, the pass to Freak. Shot clock at 6. To the left wing. Releases. Shot misses. Excellent D there from Aflalo. To the left wing. Lets the 3 fly. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
Carmelo Anthony showing you his passing skill there.
Making a change here. Amundsen's checked in. Lopez against Hayward. Now here's Freak. He's guarded closely. Favors sets the pick for Burke. Kicks it to Freak. Shot clock at 5. The Jazz with another miss. And so it's New York with it. 4-point game. And Aflalo kicks to Anthony. Let's it go from 14. And the shot no good. A bit short. And an intentional foul right there.
There's a foul.
And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. And he does get the second one. And that puts them up by 5. Guys, a critical time for them in this ballgame.
No room for mistakes right now.
Galloway, the pass to Carmelo. And it's Anthony again missing. And the foul on Carmelo Anthony. And so
Carmelo's
he's picked
fouled
up his
out.
Final foul. Will sit for the rest of this game.
You can't be happy about it, but honestly, at this point, the game's probably out of reach anyway.
Jose Calderon has checked in for the Knicks. He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. Lyles checked in for Gordon Hayward. And the second of 2 is good. That increases their lead to 6. Calderon dishes to Amundsen. Calderon has the open look. Utah with the rebound. And they go to the intentional foul.
I don't know where my guy is.
My guy's there. First of 2, no good.
He's giving it.
And he ends up making the second, and that makes it a 7-point lead. There's 14 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Galloway kicks to Aflalo. Amundsen, the pass to Galloway. Amundsen dishes to Galloway. New York, no good that time either. And so it's Utah with the win. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin, I sense that as well.
Good win, good win, good win. Worked hard, huh? Good win.
Hi, Kevin. Derek.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now let's move on to the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Gordon Hayward. He had just an outstanding fourth quarter performance. He really had the fire lit under. And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson.
As I was saying,
MLL.
Got a real big problem. All this kiddie stuff, your evil twin CC and Dom got you doing a. Vet, what was that word he was using?
Rebrand?
No. Recalibrate. All this stuff they got you doing to recalibrate your image has cost you in the hood, fam. Yo, the streets is watching, and they're not convinced.
Vic, how many times do I have to tell you? The streets ain't always right.
Nah. It's always good in the hood. Let's not forget, I am a student of human nature.
Right? You're a student of stupidity,
man.
Playing
this here video game is to not address the reason why his brand Jordan sneakers are sitting on store shelves collecting dust.
Ooh.
Ouch.
Okay, what are your suggestions, Victor?
He wants you to rob a bodega. I'm sorry.
Look, man, I'm not talking about some focus group, all right? I'm talking about the hood. They don't trust you no more. They see you coming to the arenas wearing them tight pants y'all ballers be wearing. Your high water ankles be showing. Your pants is just so tight, man. Your ankles be choking. Air it out some. People don't see themselves in you anymore. Look at me. People don't recognize themselves in who you are. If you want to recalibrate, fine, B, go ahead. Recalibrate back to Harlem. Remind these fools where you from. Represent, you know what I'm saying? Like, where's that Jesus piece you used to rock? Not that Shuttlesworth.
With them fake chains we used to wear.
Yo, but that's my point. Yo, let me get you some nice jewels, huh? Make it flossy. Get you a new whip, something that the hood will love. Let's remind these fools that you the Harlem Renaissance up in this piece. Get a club, I don't know, something. Just like a wait around, man.
I mean, at least get me some, too.
Yeah, and get some nice free bet, too.
Nah, but for real, in all seriousness, you think it's that bad?
Yo. Cass be laughing at your corner.
He's looking at the Vic, really.
But that's what I'm saying. Yo, we could change all that. Hey, now, I know CC's your manager and all, but everywhere she leads, you can't always follow. Now, I'm not trying to catch no charge, but CeCe got people out here laughing at you, fam. Now, just let me take care of everything. You're the CEO, I'm the CFO, Chief Flossing Officer. You hit me with that bread, and I got you.
CeCe.
How y'all doing?
CeCe.
Freak, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah, what up?
In private?
CeCe, go ahead.
Okay, well, I thought we were supposed to be having a private meeting today to discuss business.
CeCe, what you think we're doing?
Am I talking to you? You know what? Y'all ain't talking business. Y'all talking nonsense.
We were actually discussing the questionable nature of the promotional strategy that you and Dom have employed on Freak's behalf. And how it doesn't necessarily resonate with his core fan base, primarily due to the fact that it negates the legitimacy of his personal background and history in favor of reaching a larger, primarily more disinterested demographic that would prefer to judge Freak's past as opposed to appreciate
it. Yeah, buddy.
Yo, what Yvette said, 4 times 25, 100.
Oh, so now you know your times tables. Yvette, occasionally proving that you're articulate doesn't mean you have business acumen. Beyond, of course, your clear mastery of basic arithmetic. We all know you can add up how much Freak makes.
Okay, Cece, that's enough.
No, you know what, Cece? You're absolutely right. And speaking of basic arithmetic, how much of Freak's money do you take?
Okay, I mean, what did I just say about
a what? A manager?
Is that what you
know? Oh, jeez. I feel like that's a distilled round family argument.
Okay, it's not just you and Freak.
Speaking of, how's that going for you?
Hey, come on.
Oh, snap!
You're gonna let her talk to me like that, really?
You need to check her out. I ain't even talking about
you.
Yo, I'm out.
You know what? I think I'll join you.
No, darlings, please. Please, have a seat. I would just love to hear what you all were just discussing. Better yet, let me guess. Hey, yo, I'm saying, dude, what you need to do is hit up these parties. Yeah, you need to show these fools how you still have mad love for the hood. Get you some flossy jewels. Make sure every time they see you, it's in the new whip. Better yet, let's get us a dealership or a club or something. Never mind that house you promised your twin sister, you promised you'd get for your parents who are still in the projects where you left them.
Yo, that's not fair. I ain't leaving my ass.
Hey,
and you know I'll never leave my parents in projects.
Thing, fam. I'll take care of everything. All you gotta do is break me off with that bread. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, boy.
Wow. You know what, Cece? I don't know what's going on with you tonight, but I think it's best you go home. We will continue our meeting here.
You asking me to leave?
Yes.
Hey, yo, Freak. It's all good, man. As a matter of fact, Cece, now I know you don't like me. You never have. Now, I don't know what I ever did to you. But at this point, does it really matter anymore? Look, I just want you to know that I'm really sorry. But whatever it was, I can honestly say it was not intentional. Right? You freak. Think about what I said earlier, man. I ain't trying to catch no charge. Bet, you ready?
Let's bounce.
See. Hey, you know I love you more than life itself.
And how come you always put them before me? I don't put anyone above you, not even myself.
You sure about that, Cece? What would you just call all this? I mean, you come in here, blowing up my spot, and you insult my brother?
He's not our brother.
You disrespect my woman.
He's trying to protect you.
From who? From the likes of you? But you don't think I realize that I have vultures and blood-sucking leeches in my life? Don't think I realize that you're one of them?
Blood-sucker?
Yeah, but you know what? That's what I think the problem is. Because you realize you're no better than them and you're ashamed. But in fact, you're worse. Because we share the same blood. And just because they don't have the same blood running through their veins as us, doesn't mean that they don't love me. Yeah, their love might be flawed, but it's true. What you need to understand is I don't need you to protect me anymore. I don't mind the people closest to me leeching off me. Yes, you do leech off me, and I leech off you too. You love business and you love me. I use that. Vic? You know you don't mind running these streets. He's my connection to things I don't want to deal with anymore, so I let him do him. I take care of him, and in return, he looks out for me in places you know you can't. And as much as you don't want to hear this, Yvette, she is the eye of the storm in my life right now. She is my only calm. She's my peace.
Shelter.
I use these people and they use me. I just don't call it that, Cece. I don't call what you do using me. I call what you do caring for me. Forgive yourself and forgive them for using the resources at their disposal to get what they need. And what you need to learn to do is
Just trust me. Okay, I've always had a good judge of character, even before I was born. Remember? Because I chose to come in this world with you. That's right. It was me and you in the womb just kicking it.
Right? Just kicking it, babe.
Right?
I was born first.
And you were.
Ellie's first.
Swish.
Some people say you're just a hanger-on, that you're a leech. Why is that the word?
Because people just don't know.
They be hating?
They be hating. They hating on my game. They hating on our friendship. See, FOF, friend of freak. See, nobody got that like I do. And everybody else wants that. Who doesn't? But that's my boy. I'm in that spot. That is my lane. And everybody else just got to make way for that, you know?
That's him, but who are you?
Nah, man, I got my own life, you know? People think I'm just sitting back and riding on him, but that's not the case, yo. I got dreams. I got dreams, yo. See, my boy knows, right? There's two ways that I could do this. I could do it a legit way, or I could do it the crooked way. And I'm really, really, really trying not to do it the crooked way, but Freak can't help me do that.
He'll put you on?
Maybe. You got to do what you got to do when you need to do it to get ahead.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I do, and I'm just really good at it. What can I say? I get by day, step by step.
I take a little bit of break and be right back. Take care, everyone.
To come, jump back to my.
want you to know that it's our time. You and me bleed the same light. I want you to know that I'm all yours. You and me are on the same course. I'm slipping down a chain.
Be right back. I don't want to actually put this on the. Is there a way to. Is it on the second C? Be right back.